Hey folks, this is Sebastian. This is our follow-up video to our FIFOX Home Lab Challenge about pressure. If you don't know what I'm talking about, check out the original challenge video. This is only the discussion and explanation. Before we start, there are two people I want to mention as a shout out. The first one is Giovanni Organtini, who is a professor at the University of Rome. He's following our example and doing home lab challenge with FIFOX in Italian. So if you speak Italian, you might want to check out his videos. There will be a card in one of the corners on YouTube, also a link in the description. And the other one is Holger Essen-Thiessen, who sent us the idea for this pressure experiment almost 2 years ago on Twitter. Okay, so now for the actual experiment. The question last time was if the pressure in an inflated bag changes if you place an apple first on a smaller surface and then on a larger surface. So the question was, will the pressure in the bag increase, decrease, or stay the same? And the pressure for the smaller surface was already visible in our challenge video. It was 1026.4 hectopascal. And for the larger surface, I stopped the video before you could see the result, because otherwise why should I ask you what the result would be. For the larger surface we got 10,026.2 hectopascal. You might now think this is a very small relative change, but you have to consider that there's already 1,024 hectopascals as environment pressure on that day. So we actually have a change of 2.2 to 2.4. This is still a much smaller change than you would expect, but we will discuss this later. So what would you expect? Well, the pressure actually follows the force on your surface divided by the surface area. That's pretty much all. One thing you might consider, which you need to think of to be exact, is that as we placed the apple as a mass on there, it applied a force to gravitational acceleration. So you have to say it's the mass of the apple times the gravitational acceleration, which is 9.81 meter per square second. That's the number we see all the time over the surface area of our little cardboard piece. So nevertheless, Earth's acceleration is the same, the mass stayed the same because I didn't bite a chunk out of the apple between both experiments. So what changed was the surface area, and quite obviously the surface area of this large piece is more than twice the surface area of the smaller piece. So in fact we would have expected the pressure to halve, or the pressure on top of the environmental pressure to halve. That's not what we see, and in fact it's really hard to get exact measurements with this method. This is not because of the sensor in our smartphone, this is extremely precise, but it's due to using this bag. If you were to do the experiment with an actual piston, so you got a tube like this and a cap on top which is movable but also sealed, so the air in here is sealed off, and you place your apple on top of this, so this is supposed to be an apple, I think you can recognize it, and you compress the air this way, it probably would give much better results. I don't have such a device, so I cannot try it, but the problem with the bag is, if you inflate your bag, it afterwards usually looks something like this. It definitely doesn't have a flat surface where you place your apple, so you place your cardboard on here, and what you get in detail, if you look at it at the side, let's draw a little zoom in area. So this is the surface of the bag, and the surface of your cardboard is placed on top like this, and there will be a little gap over here, a little gap over there, and you effectively only have a surface area that is this large. Okay, so the apple is on top here. So you do not really get the right surface area that you would expect. This is the case if you inflate the bag too much. If you inflate the bag too little, which probably is what we did in our video, you get a slightly different scenario where this is your cardboard piece and the bag actually moves around the cardboard like this. Okay, so it's pressing into the bag. So I think that's what most of you would have seen. Unless you really inflated the bag tightly, you would have seen something like this. And what happens here is, while your apple is pressing down on the surface, you get surface tension at the sides, pretty much in every part of the bag, but here at the sides they do not really compensate at this curved area, and they actually counteract the force that you are creating on top of the surface. You could also see it in a different way. Over here, still the pressure works against the, so in this area, the pressure works against your cardboard pressing down. So you would have something like a virtual larger surface area. Okay. And it's really difficult to get rid of this problem with when using such a plastic bag, because you actually have to inflate it to the right amount that it's just flat when you place your cardboard on top of this, and after you apply to your weight to it, or after you place your object on top of this. So what might help is using a larger bag, where you have more possibilities to control the pressure to get a flat surface, but in the end it's really tough to get exact measurements. That's why I only asked whether the pressure would increase or decrease in this experiment, instead of asking for exact values. So the answer is yes, for a larger surface the pressure decreases. So what we learned today is that with increasing force applied to the surface, the pressure in this seat of area will increase. That's not surprising for most of you, I think. And the other thing, which was the actual answer to our experiment, is that with increasing surface area, the pressure actually decreases. So I think that's all there is to say about this experiment. Tomorrow there will be the next home lab challenge. I hope to see many of you again. Until then, stay healthy. See you tomorrow.